Hello, dear learners. I am Professor Jaseem Ahmed from IISc, Faculty of Education, Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. Today, in this discussion, I am going to talk on the topic Agency and Autonomy of Teachers and the objectives of this discussion would be that after this presentation, you will be able to define teacher autonomy in your own words. You will be able to define teacher agency in your own language. You will be also in a position to describe the significance of teacher autonomy and teacher agency in the process of teaching and learning. You will be in a position to explain the need of teacher autonomy. You will be also able to enumerate various elements of teacher agency. You will be in a position to strengthen your agency as teacher and explain the term teacher as reflective practitioner. You will be in a position to describe the benefits of being the active member of professional bodies, professional association, and finally, you will be in a position to describe the role of schools in strengthening teacher agency. Teacher autonomy, teacher agency, and teacher motivation are positively correlated and results in the active engagement of teachers in teaching and in producing good results in terms of learning outcomes. So, if you want better learning outcomes, you have to take care of these variables. Teacher autonomy means the professional independence of teachers, with a special reference to the degree of their independent decision regarding what they teach and how they teach. Let us first talk about what to teach. What to teach is related to the syllabus, the course of study which the teachers are supposed to teach in the classroom in various papers. As we all know that the syllabus is designed by, formulated by a curriculum design committee, a syllabus design committee. And in those committee, representative of the teachers are always present. Hence, we can say that directly or indirectly, teachers are teaching the content as per their own choices. And in this way, autonomy is there with the teachers regarding what to teach. As far as how to teach is concerned, we all know very well that the teachers are supposed to be the king of the class. They are the person who decides how to teach, what methods they are going to use in the classroom, what teaching strategy they are going to apply in the classroom, what activities they are going to apply in the classroom, what sort of teacher-learner interaction will go in the classroom. These all are decided by the teachers themselves. Hence, we can say that teachers always enjoy full autonomy in the classroom. Now the question is this autonomy threatened at any point of time? Now let's see, when teacher is put to be involved in other works, leaving the classes behind and the teaching is hampered. For example, you must have observed, you must have experienced that when the teachers are involved in some other works, like collection of data. In the case of Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, there has been different committees like school management committees, village education committees, block resource center, cluster resource center, management of midday meal. In all these activities, teachers are engaged in some or the other functions. And at that point of time, when teachers are involved in these activities, certainly some level of, some sort of classroom transactions are hampered. Now, we have to decide whether this aspect of hampering of classroom teaching learning process is supposed to be threatening to the autonomy or not. So, this is the subject of discussion and deliberation. But of course, these are the functions which are to be done by the teachers, because teachers are the highest number of employees in terms of government service, and they are supposed to do these functions as a in the form of national contribution. As a whole, teacher enjoys full autonomy, and this automatically gives authority to the teachers how to run the academic activities of your class. Autonomy and authority automatically puts duties and responsibilities on teachers, which each and every one of us, each and every teacher must remember throughout our career, throughout our teaching learning process. Now, the question arises, why autonomy is important? NCF 2005 states, teacher's autonomy is essential for ensuring a learning environment that addresses children's diverse needs. As much as the learner requires space, freedom, flexibility, and respect, the teacher also requires the same, because it is the teacher who looks after the needs and aspirations of the learners. If they don't enjoy autonomy, how will they perform their noble duty? Hence, teacher autonomy is important as far as teachers are performing their professional duty with dedication and producing good results. To perform with full autonomy and productivity, teacher needs to strengthen his or her agency. Now, let's see what is teacher agency. Teacher agency is basically the ability of teachers to demonstrate the capacity to solve pedagogical problems or any challenges relating to their teaching and learning. It includes teachers' capacity to create overall environment and resources for effective teaching and learning, his or her ability to act or to exert the power of knowledge and experience, taking initiatives, performing demonstration and activity to make his teaching joyful, entertaining, learning-oriented, and motivational for himself and for the learners as well. Teacher agency is the capacity of teachers to act purposefully, to direct their professional growth and contribute to the growth of their students and colleagues. It is professional action of teachers based on their perceptions and experiences to fulfill the duties, responsibilities, and accountability to respond to educational dilemmas coming in their ways of teaching and learning. The more powerful is your teacher agency, the better will be the teacher performance. You, as a teacher, have to work on strengthening teacher agency. It is your duty and responsibility to sharpen your professional skills as teacher for the needs and aspirations of students, shaping their personality and playing active role in nation building process. Now the question is, how to strengthen the teacher agency? Take first point, for strengthening your teacher agency, you have to act as a reflective practitioner. So, you have to play the role of a teacher as a reflective practitioner. Reflect to yourself on what you read, what you teach, how you teach, what you do. Ask critical questions to yourself and find the answers on your own. In the process, you will certainly improve and strengthen your teacher agency. Take reflections on your teaching and other academic activities from your students and colleagues. Work on their reflections with positive attitude. Now, you should also reflect to the ideas of others, that is your students, your colleagues, any other professionals in your field, policies of the government. This will sharpen your professional skills in teaching and learning. You should also write your reflections in the form of scholarly articles. These steps and actions on your part will certainly improve your teacher agency and develop high level of confidence and professionalism in you. Now come to the second important point in this regard, teacher as learner. By acting on the idea of teacher as a reflective practitioner, you are basically putting yourself as learner. This is what we call as teacher as learner. Whatever you think differently, just speak up, write it down, share and take others' ideas on that. Attend seminars and conferences and present papers in those conferences. Attend in-service program to make you updated. These in-service program are organized by NCERT, SCERT or any other agencies. These are meant for your professional growth and to improve upon your teaching learning process. Then attend workshop webinars on the topic of your choice. Share your ideas in academic groups within and outside the school. By practicing these academic values, you are basically improving yourself and sharpening your professional skills. Third is, for sharing your academic works and reflections, you need a larger professional community. So you should become teacher as an active partner of professional learning community. For this, you need to be a member of some professional learning community. For example, if you are a science teacher, you can take the membership of National Science Teachers Association. If you are a science teacher educator, you can be the member of Association for Science Teacher Educators. If you are interested in the field of language learning, you can be the member of Association for Language Learning. Similarly, there are so many associations, so many professional bodies. You can join them and you can update yourself and you can sharpen your proficiency in the field of teaching and learning. So you can share your ideas and experiences and make yourself updated. Hence, we can conclude by saying all ways and means of professional growth and updating of self to perform better in class and in professional work strengthen agency of the teacher. Now the question arises, what school should do in this regard at its own level? A school system should certainly support in the strengthening of teacher agency as it is the strongest tool of social change. It should include teachers in decision-making process pertaining to academics. It must support innovative activities taken up by teachers. School should provide funds for professional growth of teacher. School authorities and management must give appreciation, reward to the best performing teachers and the teachers who perform differently. It will pave way for others to go for innovation. School must make all professional learning decisions only in serious consultation with teachers. If the morale of teachers are high, they will automatically driven towards better performance and better results. We must focus on raising the social respect and high morale of our teachers. Because teachers are the real nation builders. They are the real heroes. It is the teacher who produces all professionals. Dr. D.S. Kothari, the chairman of National Education Policy 1968, rightly remarked that the destiny of India is being shaped in its classrooms. So, dear friends, we discussed in this presentation about teacher autonomy, teacher agency, and how a teacher can make his agency as a powerful tool by becoming reflective practitioner, active learner, and by becoming an active member of relevant professional associations. Thank you so much. Thank you very much.